Welcome to another Minnesota Fats. Today we are at the 2022 Smokin' Show at the Sherburne County Fairgrounds. And as you can see behind me, I got lots of Peterbilts, Kenworths, a lot of American flags. That's just the way this country should be. We'll just take a look at some of these things. A lot of the local fellers, Lefebvre, Playstead, Triple L. Collins Brothers. I like this one. It's got kind of that scoop. Not so much that, but the way this cab just kind of goes up and around. Not so much a fan of the new ones.
No, you get into the bigger sleeper trucks. Yeah. Well, I'm not an open road driver.
Snoopy. These guys do that long haul. And they got matching trailers. It's kind of nice. Look at that beauty. I love the round headlights. Got them chicken chasers up there. It's another Lefebvre transport. Look at that. Got that square body. Hood's up, but you'd never be able to see in there. That thing's up there so high. It's a good restore. Hey, there's me. Not quite sure why that camera light is on. It's pretty clean. You can see where they painted over a little rust with the scale, but not bad. That's a thing of beauty right there. That's Collins Brothers, one of the local wrecking services. They got various tow trucks and they're here with Bruda's Towing. Bruda's got a big crane too. Novco, those guys used to haul boats when I worked at the boat shop. Look at that. He's got like 10 inch stacks. A big old Mack truck. Looks like another. Oh, that's Morel. Oh, he caught something with that. That stack is bent. I bet that made him happy. I really like this blue and white thing coming up, or teal. Ooh, there's 10-inch stacks on this thing too. She's been hot. Look at that. But I think of all these old trucks, aside from them round headlight ones, got them flat fronts. It's just something that screams classic trucker. Got a Freightliner, and then that red and white one, got them proper colors. It's international. Tool for the job. Can insta this guy. This guy's got like 12-inch pipes. But everything here is hydraulics. It's all on air, the front bumper. Everything, this whole truck will bounce and bob around. Kind of nice how got that IH keep coming up into the videos. Miss you, buddy. Got a friend. Got some propane power here. Minneapolis Moline.
Alright, here comes Lane Lysol. 268.35 feet. The Lane Lions doll on his 1955 Minneapolis Moline GB Propane, where you taste the meat and not the meat. Here comes Chad Hawk on 65 Minneapolis Moline M670. Chad Hawk on a 1965 Minneapolis Moline M670. He too is burning propane.
Standing over here now.
Oh, that'll change as soon as he gets about right here.
You know?
What? It's Eric's truck.
Shit, I think Luke's got a lot of money on this. so I'm in sport anyways.
Have fun driving at home.
2,500.
That concludes this part of the video. Stay tuned. We're going to go out to eat. Not sure where. That'll be tomorrow, but you guys will see it right next. Thank you so much. Hope you enjoyed the polls. Hey, everybody. Welcome to Minnesota Fats here on this second half. We're going to do a food review for you. But I'm going to just kind of slightly cover that first half of the video. I wasn't able to get every single pole brought in or view of every tractor. Most of the tractors were in the pits, and, you know, so all we really got to see were the semis. On them tractor pulls, if you were an international, you either took first or second. That's all there was to it. The John Deere's, they... Well... Yeah. There's a couple Alice Chalmers in there. Deutz Alice. They were respectable. But it was fun. It was fun. That was... Started at 5 p.m. We got out of there. Jeez. At least 9, maybe a little after. It was a little after. I think it was like 9:15, 9:20 by the time we rolled out. So, either way, we're going to go try Bella's Ice Cream in Hopkins. Its heat index is about 90. Tomorrow is going to be triple digit heat index, and working in a warehouse, that's not going to be fun. So we're going to try some ice cream out today. Maybe I might sneak through and get some ice cream tomorrow for next week's video. We'll see. I don't know. Do you guys care about ice cream? Comment down below. You know, what do you want me to do more reviews on? Do you want some Hispanic, some Asian, you want ice cream, you want bakeries, or just kind of keep it random, keep it switching up. Let me know. You know, it's least I can do to keep you all coming back. So we're gonna go get some ice cream. Bella's Ice Cream Shop. Hello. Hey. Sure, no problem. Yeah.
Oh, some of our popular ones are, we have a North Country Crunch. That one's really popular.
What's in the North Country Crunch?
That one's a butter pecan base with praline pecan and Oreos.
Okay. What's Mac Daddy?
Mac Daddy is the butter pecan base as well with just the Oreos.
Oh. And then Marshmallow Man? That's just like vanilla with marshmallow?
I think it's like a marshmallow vanilla base.
Okay, and what's taro?
Taro's really good. It kind of tastes like a sweeter vanilla.
Oh! I think I'll try that North Country Crunch.
Do you want to sample it or just go for that one?
We'll just go for it.
And then what size would you like?
We'll go waffle cone. So here's my ice cream. I got a double scoop because they were out of waffle cones. So this ice cream is a chocolate base with, chocolate base with English toffee or butter toffee, some type of a toffee. It's either English or butter. I believe it was English toffee. So it's chocolate base with English toffee and walnuts. That's pretty new to me. That's quite the combo. It's good. It is good. This is it's not as soft as soft serve, but yet it's not like gonna break that plastic spoon, you know. It's not really frozen. You'll go to some places and it's just super frozen. But either way, this stuff is really good. I definitely want to come back, try a couple other flavors there. If I can, I'll post them up over here on the side, what I'm thinking about. I got to try to figure out how to get the menu in these things better. I don't know if... Let me know. Is my pictures better? Should I do a video of them? Or do you guys just want me to put a link down in the description, and if you're interested, you can click the link and go to the menu. I guess that works for people's phones, but if you watch it on a TV, then you're kind of, I don't know, you're kind of stuck. So it's kind of why I like to do pictures or videos, but I've messed up on my pictures on the last couple. I didn't know I could really resize it. So I apologize for that. I'm learning. I've been doing this since November, so we're a little better than half a year at it. And I thank you all for your support. Like, comment, subscribe as always. Tell a friend. If you guys want to be part of the video, let me know. We'll go out and we'll do something. Otherwise, if you just want to come along and hang out and then not be a part of the video, just I'll narrate and, you know, we'll put a couple little words up here, and you don't even have to be on camera. We can just totally keep it as anonymous guest. So up to you. If y'all want to come with, cool. If not, that's cool too. I respect that. You folks take care. Have a very wonderful week. And may God bless.